Now, we all know that the Maps app will get us from point A to point B easily. But it can also help us look up information. This is actually one of my favorite ways to use the Maps app. I primarily don't use it to get from point A to point B. What I use it for is to look up information, such as business hours, or if I'm going to a restaurant, what the menu is, or if I need to call them, what the phone number is. Let's take a look at how we can look up information and save that information in the Maps app on the iPhone. Now, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at looking up information with the Maps app on the iPhone. Let's go over to my iPhone. Now, the first thing we need to do is we need to open up the Maps app. So let's go ahead and open up the Maps app here. And now what I would like to do is I would like to look up some information. Maybe what I'd like to do is see what the hours are for one of my favorite restaurants in Holland here, Hops at 84 East. Or maybe I'd like to look at the menu. Well, we can easily do that through the Maps app. All I need to do is just search in here for what I'm looking for. In this case, it's Hops at 84 East. So I type in here, Hops, and you're going to see Hops at 84 East. If I'm not sure what the name is, I can also search nearby, and it'll give me all the locations nearby. But I know that this is what the name is, so I'm just going to tap on that. And now I'm looking at the information for that particular restaurant. So what am I looking at here? Well, if we look, you're going to see that I can call them, I can visit their website, and I can view their menu. I can also see that they are open, as well as what the average cost is and how far it is away from me. You want to look at different reviews and pictures? You can do that as well. This is pulled through Yelp. The Apple Maps partnered, or Apple's Apple Maps partnered with Yelp to get this information. I keep swiping up. We also have Good to Know. They have takeout, wheelchair accessible, good for kids, street parking, things like that. And when I swipe up here a little bit, I can also see what the hours are. So maybe I'd like to go tomorrow and I'm not sure how late they're open. I tap on this and now I can see that they're open till 12 a.m. tomorrow. And then again, if I wanted to call them, get directions to them, or visit the website, I can do that as well. Let's take a look at another business. What we're going to do is we're going to go to Discount Tire. This is where I get my tires rotated. So I type Discount Tire. And we can see that it is closing soon. And when I tap on this, what I'm able to do is call them or visit the website. And again, I can see that it is closing soon. I swipe up, I get reviews from Yelp, and I keep going. I can also see under Good to Know that they accept credit cards and contactless payments such as Apple Pay. I want to see what their hours are. Tap on this, and I can see what their hours are. So on Saturday, they're open till 5. Or maybe I'd like to get the app. It shows me the app. I can tap on that to get the app for Discount Tire to create an appointment. And again, we have our phone, website, and the address. So as you can see, we can use the Maps app to get all kinds of information about various businesses. The next thing that you might want to do with these is save them to the library. The Apple Maps has a library. When I close this, I tap on the X to close this card. What you're going to see is library here. What I'm able to do is save different locations, different businesses to this library for easy access. Let's go ahead and open this up. To open up the library, what we do is we just go down to this area here because the library is split up into different categories. I tap on it, and you're going to see I have pinned places, guides, and routes. And I can save all of these over into this library. So what I would like to do is save that Discount Tire to this library so I have easy access to it. How can I do that? Well, basically, we just go back over to our Discount Tire. It's under my recently viewed. And then to save it to the library, all you do is just tap on the plus. When I tap on the plus, you're going to see it says in library there, and now it just added it to my library. When I add it to my library, I have a new option here. I can add a note to it. Now, this is a note for me. It's a personal note. It does not make it public. So if I wanted to put a note in here about my tires, I could do that. So then when I go there, I can see that note. Let's go and add hops at 84 East. I go over here, I tap on it, and again, I tap on the plus. Now that's in my library. So now I just close this. And again, we go back over here to our library, just tap on where it says 7 places, 4 guides, 3 routes. And you're going to see I have hops at 84 East. So as I said, this is divided into different areas here. So if I go under places, you're going to see all the places that I added, including the last two that I added there. But also what we're able to do is pin a place. So with Discount Tire, since I go there on a regular basis, what I would like to do is pin that. This list here in the library can get pretty long, as you can see, because we can add all kinds of stuff in there. So what we can do is we can pin any one of our locations. So let's go with Discount Tire. I want to pin that. And when I do, what it'll do is it'll add it to the pinned category here. So now I have easy access to it. So I can see that I have Discount Tire here. To remove a pin, let's go back over there. To remove a pin, all you have to do is just swipe over to the left and it'll remove it. Now you may think that you could just swipe to the left to delete that as well, but I've seen some inconsistency. This is with iOS 18. I can't swipe to get rid of that. So how do we get rid of this? Well, we tap on the 3 dots, and then what we're able to do is delete it from the library. So in some cases, you're going to be able to swipe to the left. In other cases, you just tap on the 3 dots. All right, so that's how we can look up information as well as save it to our library. What else can we do? Well, another thing that we can do is we can view guides. What do I mean by that? Well, if we look here in my library, I have 4 guides. I tap on it, and now what I'm able to do is view Amsterdam's finest street art. I tap on that, and it's like I'm looking at a book here, and we have all kinds of information about street art in Amsterdam. And this is a guide. So how did I find this guide? Well, basically, all we have to do is just go back over to our main search here, and we just search. So let's say I'm going to San Francisco. I want to see the guides for San Francisco. I type in here San Francisco, and look what we have, guides. I tap on that, and now I'm able to view all of the different guides in here. So here's one that is the best sandwich spots in San Francisco. I'd like to view that or even save it to my library. I tap on it. I can read it. And then if I want to add it to my library, tap on that. It adds it to my library. Close that. I can keep swiping up. Let's go with the 10 best views in San Francisco. Tap on it. Yeah, that looks pretty interesting. Add it to the library. And when I do, it adds it to the guides in my library. So now when I close this and we go to my library, so I just tap on this again, you're going to see under guides the last two guides that I added there. Now, in addition to having these guides here, we're able to create our own guides. We can even create folders. So if we look here, you're going to see that I have a folder here with 2 guides in there. How do I do that? Well, basically what we need to do is we need to tap on the plus. And let's just call this one Holland, Michigan, where I live. And I would like to add different places to this. So right now I don't have anything in there. I need to create my own guides. So what I do is I tap on it, and then I tap on add a place. And we want to add 84 East in there, of course. And now that's added in there. Or let's say I wanted to add a trail. So we have Riley Trails here. Tap on the little plus, and now that's added to my guide. We're going to go with one more. Let's go and add Park Theater. This is a nice little theater that we go to for live music. So I want that in my guide. I tap on the plus. And now when I look at my Holland, Michigan, you're going to see that I have those three places in there. And when I pull this down, watch what happens. I can see where they are located on the map. So now if I wanted to go to the Park Theater, I tap on that and watch what happens with the map. It shows me where it's at here. I want to see where Riley Trails is. I tap on Riley Trails here and again watch the map. It shows me it's up here. So that's how we can create our own guides. We can just add different places to it and even guides to that. We can add guides to our own guide. So that is basically how we can create guides. Another thing we can do is we can look up park information, look up hiking trails as an example. So Riley Trails is a popular place here where we can go hiking. So I'm just going to look that up here. And you're going to see Riley Trails. I tap on it. And now it's going to give me information about that particular park. First of all, it is in my guide, and I have the website for it. And if I swipe down, I can see different information about it from Yelp. Let's look up Sleeping Bear Dune. This is up north. So I'm going to type in here Sleeping Bear. This is a dune that you really don't want to climb. And you're going to see that this one we have trailheads. So when I tap on trailheads, I can actually see the different trails at Sleeping Bear Dune. And when I tap on one of them, let's go ahead and tap on this one here, Heritage Trail, I can create my own custom route. So if I wanted to go hiking on that trail, I would tap on that. And then from here, what I do is I just start tapping where I want to create my trail. So we're going to zoom in here a little bit. And let's just say I wanted to hike from here down to here. So all I do is I just put it at the starting point, tap. You can see it put it there. And now I put it at the ending point. And you can see that it followed a trail there. I can see what the height is. And then this is going to be an out and back. So I tap on out and back. And now I can see that that is going to be 2 miles. Not a lot of elevation shift in there. And if I wanted to save this, I can save it. And guess where it'll save it to? My library. So let's go ahead and save that. I tap on done. And now that has saved. So let's go to my library. Close this all out. We go over here to my library. And when I do, we can see that it is in there. And it's going to be under routes as well, because this is a route. And there it is, South Branch Road. So in our library, I can easily go to my pinned places, my regular places that are not pinned, as well as see my guides and see my routes that I've saved. So that is how we look up information with the Maps app on the iPhone. It's one of my favorite ways to look up information. I don't go to Safari, or I don't go to a browser, I don't go to Google. I use the Maps app. And with the Maps app, I'm able to then go to the website if I need to, but I can easily see the hours. I can see if they're closing soon. I have access to their phone number. And with restaurants, I even have access to their menu. If I want to save it, I can save it as a favorite place. I can pin it. And then I can also look up guides. I can create my own guides. I'm going somewhere. I'm not familiar with it. You can read more about it by looking at these different guides and save it into your own guide. And then last, you can also look up hiking trails and create your own routes. And then you can save that to your library as well. So that's how we can look up information with the Maps app on the iPhone. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can subscribe to my channel. You can share it with your friends and family. In addition to that, what you may want to do is check out danstutorials.com. Not only do I have more videos there, but I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, and I have, or I host, classes and webinars on a regular basis. So how can you help support my efforts? Well, it is a membership-based site. When you become a member of my site, what I'll do for you is I'll take out all of the ads from the videos. I'll also give you access to that AI assistant, and you have access to my classes and webinars. In addition to that, you're also helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I'm not part of some large organization. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out danstutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.